went to stamp it on this card and I didn't have enough ink on it, it didn't stamp good. And I said, well, I'll just try again, you know. You never can get it exactly right, you know, get it on the same spot. But I thought, I'm gonna try anyway. So I did, and it came out crooked, of course. But when you looked at it, it was faded back here, but then the top part was really bright, and you could see, this is the day. And I said, oh God, there's a message in this. And out of that, the Lord spoke to me. And so in Psalm 118, verse 24, that is the verse. This is the day which the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Now, you know what? This is the day. Like, today is the day of salvation. This is the day the Lord made. As that fuzziness in that thing, some days, I don't know about you, but some days aren't always perfect. You know, I wake up, don't want to get up, you know. I worked last night till as a custodian after I did my regular job for 4 hours, and I know why I quit the other job, because I couldn't walk when I was done. Mike actually had to lift me up into the house on off the stairs. My feet, I was hurting so bad, walking on that concrete for 4 hours, and mopping and sweeping and, you know, cleaning bathrooms, which I don't mind doing, but my feet just couldn't, you know. So, okay, but you know what? This is the day the Lord has made. See, they don't always come out right, you know. You know, we are arguing with our husbands, or we're, you know, overwhelmed with our kids or our parents, or, you know, what our job, our fellow workers, or whatever. But this is the day the Lord has made. See, we will be glad and rejoice. Okay? We will. God gave us everything we need, and I'm going to show you. In Lamentations, verse 3, everybody knows this scripture. Everybody's heard it. 21, it is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. His, not mine. I don't know about you, but I'm not faithful all the time. I fall all the time. But thank God for Jesus, right? Thank God for Jesus. But his mercies are new every morning. When we wake up every morning, it's a new day. It's a new day. It's a this is the day. It's not yesterday and it's not tomorrow, but it's this is the day. And I think that we are so fleshly that we lose sight of this is the day. We're so consumed in our flesh. We are. We're consumed with our flesh, with how we feel, what we think, that we can't get our minds out of ourselves and into the Lord himself. This is the day. He made this day for us. I'm sorry. After all that singing, my throat messes up on me. I do have water. If we understood the day the Lord made for us, I think we could get out of ourselves. In 1 John, I love this scripture. I never get tired of reading it. Never get tired of hearing it. Chapter 4, in verse 7, it says, beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. Then in verse 18, he says, there is no fear in love, but perfect love casteth out fear, because fear hath torment. He that feareth is not made perfect in love. We love him because he first loved us. Now, this perfect love, that's Jesus Christ himself. When we see the perfect love of Jesus Christ, how he died on that cross for you and me, he paid the ultimate sacrifice for you and me. That's perfect love. I can't, fear has no hold on me anymore. Sin. What's fear of what? We fear sin. We fear what that's going to do to us. We walk in fear because we're consumed with ourselves. Again, we're so consumed with ourselves. But when we see what Jesus did and we understand that he is the perfect love, that scripture stumped me for years. I've never, well, but I'm not in perfect love because I know I fear. But see, if we see the love of Christ, the true, what he did for you and me, then I see he's perfect, that perfect love. I'm not afraid of sin getting me. I'm not afraid of death. I'm not afraid of my job. I'm not, because, you know, things will happen. I know there was a day I was afraid I was going to lose my job. It tormented me. I was tormented with that for probably 2 years when I first started at Scope. It just hung over me, and I cried. I can tell you, I would cry every night, come home and cry. It was a horrible place, and there was this fear, this thing that just hung over me. And one day I realized they didn't own me. They didn't own me. Jesus owned me, and he's the one who determined my destiny, my future. It was not that job.
Lord.
Okay, but I was tormented because I feared. I didn't understand that Jesus, his perfect love for me, was there too.
Right.
Didn't get it. But when I got it, fear left. I'm not tormented. The torment left. I was a new person. They could say and do anything. Didn't bother me anymore.
Yeah.
Didn't matter. Lord. Same situation, same place. But I understood perfect love. Casted out the fear, and there was no torment.
Hallelujah.
So when we fear, it's because we don't understand that perfect love of Jesus. And it's Jesus. He is that perfect love.
Yeah.
We don't understand him, what he did at the cross.
Yes.
It was all at the cross. We got to always go back to the cross and see, what did he do? Sometimes we don't understand all that is involved in that. If we did, we wouldn't become so consumed with ourselves. And I really just got that tonight when we were singing, just right at the end. I just saw, oh Lord, that's it. We are so consumed with ourselves, we can't see out of the box of our daily life. Yet, God, this is the day. This is the day. Let us rejoice no matter what's coming our way. And if we keep in this is the day and rejoicing and being glad, then all those things that come at us don't matter. They just go. They're out the door. Whether it's a crabby child or a crabby boss or a bill that's due. Hey, you know what? It's not always people. Sometimes it's our circumstances. But I'm going to tell you, this is the day. He made this day too. He made the day that those bills are due. But he also made the money to pay those bills.
Wow.
And when we trust the Lord, he's right there. He'll pay those bills. You know, it is again.
That's good.
We got to keep our eyes on Jesus and get out of ourselves.
Yep.
Get out of ourselves. In Matthew 6, we all know this one too. Take no thought.
Mm-hmm.
How many of us every day take no thought? Mm-hmm. Let's take no thought. For the morrow. For the morrow shall take thought for itself. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof. Do we not realize the evil that's there tomorrow? That's why Jesus, the Bible is replete. It doesn't say tomorrow. It always says today. This is the day. Today is the day. It's never tomorrow. It's always today. Because there's enough hassle in tomorrow. You know, if God told us to be thinking about tomorrow all the time, we'd never be in the moment with him today. We'd always be lost in tomorrow.
Right.
Always in the what if, what if, what if.
How you preach?
We can't live in what if. There is no what if.
Yeah. Right.
It is today. What about today? He said, this is it.
Yeah.
Let's live today.
Yeah.
Let's get out of ourselves and live in him today. Right now, today, this day. And rejoice and be glad in this day, no matter what comes our way, because we know, David in prison, he doesn't understand. He's not there to feel sorry for himself. He's there to preach the gospel.
Woo.
Paul preached the gospel, did he not, when he was in prison?
Yes,
he didn't sit in that jail cell and feel sorry for himself. He wasn't consumed with himself. And you know, it's just, it's our flesh, but it's kind of the way we're taught too. Not only in the church, but in the world. It's always, we're always thinking about ourselves. We're always thinking about, you know, me. Let's take care of me. Gotta take care of me. But that isn't how God does that. God doesn't do things that way. God says, don't even think about yourself. What you're going to eat, what you're going to wear, right? Did he not say? He said, seek the kingdom of God and his righteousness.
Wow.
And all these things will be added. So we stay out of all me, and what about me? And then we go to the kingdom of God, see?
Amen.
And that's another thing he showed me when we were worshiping too. And I'll get to that. In Matthew 28:18, Jesus said, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth.
Mm-hmm.
What did he do with that power? You might know. What did he do with that?
He gave it to us.
He did. He most surely did. He gave it to us. He gave it to you and me. What did he give it to us for? So we can sit around and feel sorry for ourselves?
To be witnesses.
Exactly.
Yes.
To be witnesses.